Good evening, all Atmas. Today we are going to see Bhagavad Gita Jnana Yajna, Chapter 3, Communion Through Action. This is about the Karma Yoga. The next loka is, in this world of action, unless acts are done as an offering to God, become cause of bondage. Therefore, work for the sake of God without personal attachment. So what he says is, this world of action. So this world is full of action because the entire world is formed part of nature. Nature is always active. Every living creature, whether it is in land or sea, everything created by God is always active. Even the trees, even the nature, that is the various seasons. Everything is part of nature and everything is doing their act according to their duties. So, in this world of action, as far as the human being is concerned, because animals and all, they do their act and they carry on, there is no karma for them. Animals or other natural activities like summer, winter, rainy season, all these seasons, these are all forming part of nature, there is no. But as far as the human being is concerned, there is a karma attached to him. His birth is based on these karmas. That's why he says, in this world of action, unless acts are done as an offering to God, becomes cause of bondage. So, in the evolution, if you see, right from one sense to five sense, each Atma, each forms of these living creatures, it just pass on under promotion and come to the human form. The next promotion for the human form is God. So if one wants to attain the God's level, that is called Mukti, what they have to do? They have to release their bondage. So they have already bonded themselves with the karmic factors. So each and every act done in state of ignorance is creating a karmic bondage for him. So he has to remove the bondage. So when it is possible is only when the acts are done as an offering to God. If it is not done as an offering to God, then there is an attachment, then there is an expectation, then this leads to cause of bondage. When you are supposed to do a duty, while doing the duty, the duty you should offer to the God. That's why every day when you in the morning after you get up and have your bath, you go to your puja room and offer flowers to him. What that flowers refers to is that today all my duties I am just offering to you as the form of flowers to you. I just offer it to you. So each and every action what I am doing, I am just offering to you. Please release my karmas. So each karma has bonded me. So by doing my duties, I am just releasing my karmas. So each action has got a, each action is to release the duties, is to fulfill the duties and release the karmas. So one has to release each and every karma. So if you see in Mahavishnu, God Mahavishnu is the God of fulfilling, generation, operation, destruction, God. Generation is Brahma. Operation by Vishnu, destruction by Shiva. What destroys? He destroys the ignorance of ego that leads to the attainment of Mukti. But operation means what? Right from birth to death, one has to fulfill his duties. By fulfilling duties, one releases the karmas. And this is done by God. by the Lord Vishnu. That's why in Sankhu Chakram, you have Sankhu and Chakram. Sankhu means what? See, the war of life has started when we take a birth. There is Sankhu, he is honking the Sankhu. Because your war of life has started, you have to release your karmas. And this Chakram is rotating this. That means what? You have to release each and every karma. You have already bonded yourself with this karmic bondage. You have to release the karma. So, surrender to me and do all your duties to me as an offering to me. Then each and every karma will be released. The chakram which Vishnu is holding is that shows the depiction of the truth that each person has to release his karmas by surrendering to God. That's why in these all actions have to be offered to God. Offered to God means you should do every act without expectation, because you are coming with a positive and negative karmas. You think what you are doing in the present day is an action. No, it is only we are just doing the work to release, to face the reaction to the action already done by us. So there is no question of action at all. Whatever things that we are doing, though it literally seems to be an action, but actually spiritually it is a reaction to the action already done. I am doing my duties today. Why these duties have come to me? Why this bondage have come to me? Through the bondage only I am getting duties. Other relatives, whomsoever you have relatives are there, with whom we get bonded. And this bondage is only to fulfill, this bondage gives the duties. By doing the duties, I am releasing my karmas. So I have nothing to gain and nothing to lose. I just come to release my karmas. So if that guy had to come means I have to offer everything. Whatever duties I am doing, just offer to him. When you are just offering to him, the karmic bondage releases. The karmic bondage releases. So during the process of releasing karmic bondage, there are in the thread, no, there would have been intertwined some places. Intertwined means you face certain trials and tribulations, difficulties. At that time you have to surrender to him and adhere patience to release this intertwined thread properly, slowly, with patience. That means whatever problem is there, that problems you have to handle patiently so that they not get released and the bondage get released. So that is that comes only when we surrender to him and offer everything to him without attachment. Just do the duty. I have nothing to gain, nothing to lose in my life. I have not brought anything with me at the time of birth. I am not going to do anything with me at the time of death. This birth and death is only to the physical body, not to the Atma. And Atma doesn't need anything, because Atma's only object is merge with Paramatma. That is the only object. These bodies are only a transition. They are coming in the path of transition. To release these duties, by doing those duties, it releases karma. So what I am going to take at the time of my death is not all this physical property or anything with me. I am just going to take only the good or bad karma, what I am doing in these life cycles. So if I offer everything to God, then there is no accumulation of good or bad karma to me. Everything I am surrendered to him. So what happens, this karmic bondage gets released. And that kind of mindset has to be acquired. And the sloka of Bhagavad Gita is intended to give the man the needed knowledge to realize that all these duties one should offer to him, so that each and every karmic bondage get released. Therefore, work for the sake of God without any personal attachment. That's why whatever you do, just think of him. When you face bad, when you face good, whatever the thing, you just think of him. Oh God, you have created this scene in this stage, this scene has been created. I am fulfilling it as per your instruction, and I surrender to you and just follow your instruction and do this role today. So that means what? I am just surrendering to him. So once that scene is over, my karma is finished, my duty is, oh, Sabash, you have done it well. Next scene you have to go. So like that, each and every scene you should do only according to instruction by surrendering to him. So that you complete your duties and release karmas. One who eat what is left after sacrifice are released from all sins. But those who cook food for the self alone without sharing it with others, such degraded men eat sin. So what does it mean? One who eat what is left after sacrifice. So We are while doing our duties. No? So when we come to this life, we are coming with a karma account. We have good karma, bad karma. So this good karma gives us an opportunity to join a good family, good education, good situations in life. All these things are because of good karma. And bad karma is ups and downs we come across in our life. But when a person gets an opportunity because of his good karma to earn money, to gain knowledge, all these things, when he gets it, he should not confine himself for his own selfish aggrandizement. So what is needed for me as an individual or to the persons with whom I am bonded, I need it for them to survive, I need them for money to face the situations in life. So that is my duty. I have to take care of my wife, children, all these people and feed them, give them proper education, make them to stand on their feet. In future, they should not, whatever needed is to be done. Suppose a man is earning 1 crore rupees. 1 crore is needed, is not needed for a person. And he says, because of my knowledge, because of my qualification, because of my, I gained this. It is because of my capacity I earned this money, it is only meant for me, I will not give it to anybody. Because if he restricts himself with himself, not giving to others, means he is accumulating wealth what is beyond his requirement. This wealth what God has given to you, all atmas are forming part of this world and everybody is God's creation. If somebody is having more, means there is somebody is deprived of it. So, this having what he is having more, he cannot take with him. Can he take 1 crore rupees? Every month, every year we accumulate crores and crores of rupees. At the time of death, can he take this? Nothing. He cannot take even a single pie with him. Then why God has given you? Because of good karma you got it. Okay, you are earned very good. But can you take this with you? No. Then what you have to do is, you have to, here a man is deprived of this. By giving it, you balance it. That means, to the extent of your balancing, you accumulate good karma for you. These good karmas, what happens? It annihilates the bad karmas and may go to take you in the path of mukti at the earliest. That's why he said, one who eats what is left after sacrifice. That means what? Whatever you are having. One who eats what? Eat means not only food. Whatever you earn, you have to first satisfy your micro level families. Your duties in feeding them, that is very important. If you don't do that, you accumulate bad karma. If you do that, you release your karmas. There is no accumulation of good karma in that respect. Because the family is a mandatory duty. But after fulfilling this duty, you have excess. The God, what he has given the excess, since he cannot take, that is the knowledge one has to gain. He cannot take with you. Then why he has given this? How I can take this with me is by doing a sacrifice. Sacrifice in the sense, offer it to those who are needy. Because this wealth of the world is equally to be given. God has given to every living creature to have this enjoyment of his nature, what he has created. But if somebody keeps excess, whereas somebody is deprived and suffering, starving, and this man is enjoying, by seeing he is having excess money and keeping in his coffers, and he is seeing the man suffering from starvation and doesn't take care of means he is accumulating bad karma. The money he is having, but at the same time he is accumulating bad karma. That's why. So, but one who fulfills his duties, okay, God has given me this excess. This excess I have to sacrifice. Sacrifice in the sense, one who does sacrifice, that they accumulate. They release the sins. So, sacrifice are released from all sins. So, what is an excess of fulfilling a micro duties? You have got the duties to the macro level family. When you do the duties, your sins get erased. All the sins are released. But those who cook food for the self alone, without sharing with others, such degraded men eat sin. But whereas, I am having excess money, it's my own earnings. Who has got nobody go, no government, no police can come and ask me to give. Today I am having excess food. Whereas my adjacent person, poor man in the hut, he doesn't have food for the children. And the children are starving due to want of food. But whereas I am having excess food which I am pouring into the dustbin. So here, seeing him, though there is no legal duty Suppose if I am not feeding him, if he dies, I am not criminally liable. But if I seeing him suffering from starvation, whereas I am throwing the food, excess food in the dustbin, this is a clear case of there is a lack of morality and ethical values in our life. So morality, legality is different from morality. If you lose morality or ethical values, then that accumulates bad karma. That's what he said. One who cook for self alone, I just cook for myself. Anything else I throw, I don't want to give anybody. Without sharing with others, such degraded man. So what, you are, when the world is suffering from starvation, whereas you cook food and waste it, and don't want to give anybody, means there you accumulate bad karma for yourself. You only eat sin. That is, you are just doing only for your selfish purpose, not for others. So that leads to sin. Vain is the life of that sinful and self-indulgent person who fails to fulfill his obligations in the cycle of mutual interdependence and service. So what it says is, vain is the life of that sinful person. Vain is the life of that sinful person. How is sinful and self-indulgent person who fails to fulfill his obligations in the cycle of mutual interdependence and service. Today in this world, nobody is independent. Everybody is interdependent on one body, interdependent in terms of goods and services. Suppose a man is, you got the natural resources which like iron that you buy. And with that billets or iron, you put it in the factory and make it into pipes, iron rods. This you sell through a trader. The constructor buys it, the construction company buys it, and they get the money from the person who built the house. So, and he, according to the requirement of iron rods, he buys it. So here, so many interdependence is there. I am intend to construct a house. I appoint a constructor. And the constructor, what he does, he buys the iron rod from the trader. The trader buys from the manufacturer. Manufacturer buys the raw material from the another supplier. So like that, every service is interdependent. Nobody is independent. Everybody in this world, they are interdependent. But if one of the supplier, he supplies the material, whereas the person who takes the material and he sells and may enjoy the money without repaying the money. That's what he says. Vain is the life of that sinful and self-indulgent person. That is, I enjoy the benefit of service or the material, but I won't pay back. That means I am committing a cheating. So what happens, sir? Who fails to fulfill his obligation? So after taking the material, I don't repay the money. I don't pay the money. So, but I enjoy the benefit of it. So what happens, to that extent, I am accumulating bad karma for me. That is why it is called sinful and self-indulgent. Because I am not fulfilling my obligation in the cycle of mutual interdependence and service. So one has to fulfill, every person in this world has got are interdependent on each and every person. It may be interdependence and service. It may be goods or services, anything. Even in the house, without giving money, there is you earn money, you have a family, whereas whatever money you earn, you spend for drinking. For you are involving self-indulgent in enjoying your pleasures, whereas your wife and children are suffering from starvation. Here you are committing a sin, because it is the primary duty for you to take care of them. But you are not fulfilling the duty, but involving self-indulgent in enjoying the pleasures of your earnings without fulfilling your duties. So this is a sin. So one should fulfill the duties to all those people with whom he is bonded, and from whomsoever he has received services or materials, so that when every person fulfills his duties, the interdependence of services will be perfect and there will be harmony in the society that brings the real peace to everybody. But if that is not done, then one accumulates sin. So in this Kali Yuga, 75% is adharma, 25% is dharma. So the adharma acts leads to accumulation of sin. So one should realize the Bhagavad Gita's slokas, all these things is one is to make the person to realize his real duties and what is the natural spiritual path to imbibe in the moral spiritual values to lead a successful, peaceful life and at the same time fulfill one's duties in the interdependence of this mutual interdependence in this world by which one releases the karmas and go in the path of mukti. And that is the real path of karma yogi, which the Lord Krishna explained to Arjuna in this sloka. We will see the next sloka in the next session. Thank you.